Welcome to the Rassling Show, emulating live from the epicenter of awesomeness here in Tampa, Florida. Don't forget to send your video submissions for my 2-year anniversary show. You know, where you're just saying, congratulations on 2 years. Ching! Emails right here or down below. Alright. First, what I'd like to say is, I know a lot of people are talking about, you know, MMA and stuff, and I'm not really going to talk about MMA on my channel, but I did pick up a magazine, you know, just kind of research it and see what is up. All I got to say is, I know I was talking to some senior citizens of the community, and they remember when boxing was popular, but I guess that wasn't violent enough, or their business model they were using wasn't good enough, so wrestling came, took its place, and now MMA is taking wrestling's place. I don't see how you can get much more violent than MMA, unless we're gonna start having, like, you know, go back to Roman Colosseum days where you're feeding people the lions and broadcasting it on cable. But yeah, what I have to take away from this magazine is it's a little too filled with testosterone. Like, they'll have an energy drink, it'll be called Lightning, right? And it'll have a big bolt of lightning, you know, nicely drawn and everything. But the lightning will be, like, covered in barbed wire, and that's, like, really hardcore, and it makes you want to buy it. It's just a shock to the system, because, you know, the WWE's PG, and then you go out and read this magazine, and you're like, whoa! So, yeah. Also, I'd like to clear up something from my previous video. I do not think I am better than anyone else. I thought that was just a given. You know, I never assumed that. It's just a given when you come to my channel, you should just already... Alright, let's do some news. Let's do this. Great Khali has been sued. Apparently Great Khali is a big thing in India or whatever. Not just because he's tall, but apparently he's funny in India. I guess, I mean, I don't know what he's saying. But yeah, he was basically in India. He was on a show kind of equivalent to the Big Brother over here in the States. Blah, blah, blah. Basically had contractual obligations. He was paid in advance. It was claimed. And Khali's going to court. This is like as live as you can be on YouTube. Ooh. WWE is considering to put a permanent Hall of Fame down here in Orlando, Florida. Well, over there in Orlando, Florida. I'm in Tampa, Florida, but still, that's why I call this the epicenter of awesomeness, guys and gals. Tampa, Florida, and the surrounding area is surrounded by pro wrestlers and companies and history. Research wrestling history, decades upon decades. I would say Florida, Texas, and the Northeast, maybe like New York and a few of those states up there. Texas, like I said, and Florida are, like, as far as wrestling, worldwide, they're just the most historically important, alright? But yeah, that's why I call it the epicenter of awesomeness. Everything just surrounds me. But they're considering a Hall of Fame in Orlando. Like an actual building, a permanent thing. Also, the Astrodome over in Houston has been considered, but I want it in Orlando, alright? You know, I don't know if the wrestling show can exist, because by the time they decide on this, it could be like 10 years from now, but yeah, you know, if it pops up in a year or two or whatever, at least take you through it. Hulk Hogan is getting married again! Yay! I bet you he's marrying his daughter's, like, best friend or something. He likes, you know, marrying, you know, dating young people. And it's funny because Hulk Hogan was accused, like, a few weeks ago of showing his junk or whatever. You know, his groin area. And I'm like, that's kind of odd. And Hulk Hogan's, you know, denying it. I didn't do it, brother. I'm like, that's right. Hogan would not stoop that low. Hogan just did drugs, you know, lies and cheats to get ahead in whatever company he's in. Tries to bankrupt TNA. Oh, he defended his son after his son, you know, crippled the passenger in his car, because Nick Hogan was like, well, the speed limit was like 60, and I figured, you know, 120 isn't that far over. And yeah, Hogan was like, well, he's a negative person, brother, so he deserved what he got. I'm like, I could see defending your kid. You know, that's just a parent thing. Even in heinous cases, you always hear the parent kind of sticks with the kid because you can't imagine your kid would be, you know, that big of a douchebag. But the mere fact that he had no sympathy for the other guy that got injured, who just came back from Iraq, I believe, you know, it's, I mean, your son ruined the kid's life and you're trying to, I mean, Nick should have served some years in prison. You know, if it was me, he would have served some time in prison. But what, he get like a year? No, wait, I think he got like 6 months and now he's out on probation, so. Yeah, Hogan, you're definitely my role model. What else we got? What else we got? Ooh, the new TNA belt. Some people are saying it looks like the Divas title. After some considering, you know, it's a custom Jeff Hardy belt. I mean, it's kind of got that hard rock grunge theme to it. I guess that's why it's stylized the way it is. But, yeah, all those points and stuff, it does make it look like the Divas title. That and, I mean, it's dangerous. You could stab yourself on it. I mean, custom belts, I mean, Jeff Hardy is not that big of a star, is he? If he was that big of a star, TNA's ratings would be like twos, right? I mean, he's not... I know everybody loves Jeff Hardy and someone's gonna comment. Look, he does what he does good, but overall he's not a good wrestler. He's not that good on the mic. He's not some kind of technician, you know, ring technician. He has some moves, but basically he's just kind of a, he can take a lot of beating and he can do high risk. He's kind of like Sabu with some less botches and can slightly talk better on the mic, but not really. What else we got? This is all like streaming. This is where it's a little new format here. Bret Hart. Oh, Kevin Nash says he left TNA. You know, he basically wanted to be a free man. I know, Nash, it must have been hard to bring your old, you know, father time ass into the ring. I mean, come on, they were giving you a pay cut? That's unacceptable. You deserve $1 million every time you step over the rope and, you know, you do a kick. And that's pretty much your match. I know, you work so hard in your matches. This is unacceptable. They shouldn't treat you like that. I mean, come on, Nash. You basically had free reign over what you did. You just kind of showed up, you know, and collected a paycheck. I mean, I know you're getting older, so we can't expect the same. Well, personally, I wouldn't want to see you in TNA as a wrestler anyway. But that's beside the point. At your age and the way they're pampering you over in TNA, why were you complaining? You were collecting a paycheck. Where else can you collect, even with the pay cut, where else can you collect that kind of money doing practically nothing? Oh yeah, you're traveling. Give you that. But you barely do anything. I bet you someone working at Home Depot, you know, as a greeter, probably does more physical work than you. Yeah, that's an idea. Kevin Nash, go become a Home Depot greeter. What else we got on our Twit feeds? I'm just trying something else out. I'm just kind of as blithe as I can, you know. Oh, William Regal is apparently retiring. At least they gave him mic time. And I guess, you know, it's a wrestling thing. You gotta lose your last match. I don't think this is his last match. I think this is like his last tour. And I'm reading he hasn't really retired yet. But, you know, it's good they gave him mic time. I'd rather see some wrestlers start winning on their way out. Now I could see, let's say you're an ROH, right? It's your last match in ROH. Yeah, you're going to lose because it's kind of a thing. Plus, they don't want you to have momentum as you go to another company. Understandable. But if you're like Regal and you're pretty much leaving the business, or, you know, you're not going to be an active wrestler anywhere, just let them win, you know? I know they did it with, like, Trish Stratus and stuff. But they would make them lose a lot more. And I don't know, it's kind of bitter in the end. But they gave them mic time. I understand. It's tradition. So, he was a great worker, always solid. The last few years, they pretty much jobbed him out. Now, I understand he had that little issue a few years back, but who on the roster isn't probably doing something they shouldn't be doing? And he got past that, and, you know, the WWE lifestyle, not to make excuses, does facilitate certain behaviors, so... You know. But thank you, Regal. You were usually pretty funny. You're solid in the ring. Sorry that they jobbed you the last few years. I didn't expect you to be a main eventer, but you could have been a solid guy in, you know, the Intercontinental title. You know, you could have held it once or twice for a few months just to help bring up some of the guys in the division. So thank you all for joining me, and have a great, well, week.